we were lucky enough to grow up at a certain period of time in Philadelphia, when Philadelphia was happening. It was the mecca of rock and roll in the North, anyway. And like I said, we were just there. I mean, we just experienced it all, you know. It amazes me when I look back on it.
We're part of that tradition. We're part of the tradition of soul, and it was the music of the area that we grew up in. And it was the only music I ever listened to. It was the music that meant something to me, and I guess quite naturally that means that, you know, that's the music I feel comfortable with. I think we've tried to stretch its boundaries. I think that's our challenge and our goal, and that's what we've been trying to do for the last 10 years, basically, is stretch the boundaries of what we feel comfortable with, at the same time maintaining the essence of it, which is the soul of it. It makes me just feel like crying. People are involved in the beat. The beat is happening. The beat is moving people for whatever reason. You know, just like lyrics were the focal point of 60s music and 60s consciousness when it came to meaningful music and the birth of the singer-songwriter and Dylan and all that stuff, you know, and there was a socio-political, you know, theme going on in music, and that was moving people. Well, now the groove is moving people, you know, for whatever reason, you know. People evidently want to move.
They used to have a show in Philadelphia called Summertime at the Pier, which was a guy named Ed Hurst, and it was originally out of Atlantic City, but then they also had it in Philadelphia too. And John's sister was I don't know what she had to do with the show. I don't know, she was assistant director for the show or something like that. So she said, "You guys want to come on the show?" So we did. So normally we would get up there, and you know, people in those days just lip sync their records, you know, just stand there and do it. So we said, let's do something different. We had no concept of, quote, video or whatever. We said, let's just do something strange. So we rented some costumes and brought some furniture from our house and did all that kind of thing, and it was a really bizarre video. I mean, if you saw it, you would definitely wonder where we were coming from. But it was the first video I ever saw. It actually looked like a video. To me, the late 70s were a real low point in music, and I was very frustrated, and I think, I don't know, I wasn't getting along with the musical world, they didn't like me, and I just don't think there was that much happening. And what I said was that nothing will come until what has come before is totally exhausted, and then something has to come by its natural, you know, just by its natural sense of things flowing in cycles. And I think it's actually starting to happen now. You know, I think since I said that, I feel that it's coming to pass. I mean, obviously video has a lot to do with what's becoming the next big thing. And I don't mean just because the fad of video or whatever, the fad itself will pass, but video is going to change the face of music, is in the process of changing the face of music, because it changes not only how an artist conceives of the work, but how it's being perceived by the audience. And that's where the big change is. Music is not to be just listened to anymore, as much as that might be good. And I, being a purist in some ways and a musician, I mourn the passing of that, but it's past. I think a lot of people miss our point when they analyze our lyrics. I don't think the tradition we come out of, rock and soul, soul music is not to be analyzed, it's to be felt and experienced. It's a mood, it literally goes back to religious roots. It's gospel music. And, it's a call and response and someone testifying and someone responding to that. It isn't the words themselves, it's the meaning and the mood that they invoke. And we try and do that visually, or at least that's my idea of how to deal with a video, is to try and invoke and evoke some kind of mood. I feel very satisfied musically. I don't feel satiated though. I feel like there's still a lot more to come, yeah. And we're still just scratching the surface. So it's really challenging too.
We're too busy looking ahead, yeah, to worry about what what we've done. I mean, that's done. That's in the past. And it stands on its own. People want to relate to it and think about it. Great, but we're too busy thinking about tomorrow. Shake it up.